me always do is I always tell my students, Tiffany, are you back there listening, dear? Okay. You know, this is just a metaphor for the life of this wonderful, wonderful family.
I don't understand.
Gina Pritchard doesn't like to leave her daughter Gracie, and so she's doing us a wonderful favor to come over here. And that's why we're all waiting for her. And when you have a child in the hospital who's very sick, you can't plan anything. We're very fortunate that we're here tonight. But sometimes things happen and you just can't get to great events. Gina has been coming here since Gracie was born in 98, and I remember her because I was here. Can't believe it. And she's always been a very precious and complicated little girl. When I looked in the computer today, I counted up 29 times that they have stayed here since 1998. 29 times that they've gone back and forth, some for quite long stays, some not so long, this most recent one, unexpectedly longer than they had hoped. She has a wonderful husband who's devoted to her, a gorgeous little guy now who's about 15 months, Ronnie. And I'm going to let her speak to you. She's a wonderful lady. We love her. There she is.
The first thing I want to say, just so I don't forget it in the end, is thank you. I want to tell you what all that you do means to the families that are here. And I'm a country mouse. But most of you are probably from the city or near the city. And I am 3 hours due north in a little town called Homesdale, a population of 5,000, which you probably have in three blocks here in Philadelphia. Our neighbors are anyone within a 25-mile radius, and I don't think that happens here too much. But that's where I come from. So my first time to Philadelphia was when our little girl was born, and she had reconstructed heart surgery. And our first stay here was 9 months long. It was like being pregnant twice, I tell you. My waist said so too. But anyway, I wanted to tell you a little bit about our family. At Helen Philgen, we do have a little boy too. He's 15 months old. So he's been added to the Ronald McDonald House family along with us. And it has been such a wonderful thing for us. And they're home. My husband and my little guy are home right now. My husband works during the week and he comes down on the weekends to visit with us, and we get to be together for that time, which is really nice. And they say absence makes the heart grow fonder, but I don't think my 15-month-old agrees with that so necessarily. So I get lots of cheers and hugs in the leg and don't let me go. But our family, of course, we've been coming here for 9 years now since Gracie was born. And we have spent about 400 days as an inpatient at Children's Hospital in Philadelphia since she's been born. And like I said, the first day was 9 months long. And we come down about 10 to 20 times a year, sometimes as inpatients, sometimes to see the doctors to get the checkup and hopefully get a few good words in. And that's basically how we live our lives. It's when is our next trip to Philly gonna happen? But I can tell you that none of these visits to Philly would be very, very easy at all for us if it wasn't for the Ronald McDonald House. Sometimes we come down for a visit and they say, you can't go home, Gracie's gotta be admitted to the hospital. And if you guys weren't here, we wouldn't have anywhere to go. And if you can just imagine the financial burden on a family like ours, when just before Gracie was born, we broke ground in our new home, as a lot of people do when they have their first little one, gotta do it all at once. So the doctor said, 7 to 10 days you'll be there, and 9 months later, and a lot of financial difficulties later, we went home. But if we had to pay for a hotel room, and you can imagine, I don't know if there's a hotel room in Philly that you can get for $100 a night even. But in that first 9 month period, it would have cost us $27,000. That's breathtaking to me. That's like a new Buick in 9 months. I don't know many people that can do that. I know we can't. So we realize that with the help of volunteers here, that you make the nominal fee of $15 a night possible. Because if volunteers weren't volunteers, we couldn't do that here. So we thank you for that very, very much. And for all that you give of yourselves to make this home a great home. And we do call this home. It's our home in Philly. It's our second home, and we really love it. And you allow our families to be together, and sometimes you allow us to be apart in a safe place. So my husband is home during the week, and he doesn't worry about where I am. He doesn't worry, you know, gosh, is she in a safe place? How is that hotel? You know, how is the neighborhood around there? We don't worry about that. Isn't that a nice thing not to worry about when you've got heart surgery going on over there? That's where your worries need to be, not where you're going to stay that night. That's for sure. And it's a clean place. We don't have to worry, are we going to take something to our little ones? All I want to take to her is hugs and kisses. We don't want to take anything else. So the house is always clean. And the fantastic food, oh my gosh. If anybody leaves this place hungry, it is their own fault. You can't leave this place hungry. And we don't, ever. Big waistlines here, but we love them. And the pretty landscaping outside. I don't know if a lot of families even have the time to walk outside in the morning to breathe the fresh air and see the gorgeous landscaping out there. I mean, in the summer, like in the springtime, there's flowers out there, there's trees, it's well cared for, and you just walk out there and you can breathe in all that stuff. It's just beautiful. And not only that, but all the fun things that you have for our kids to enjoy, the playrooms. In 9 years, we've seen this place metamorphosize in 9 years. They remodeled the kitchen last year. They added a new playroom, I think, 2 years ago. And the kids just love it. It just lets them know that, you know what, sometimes it's okay to be a kid. You don't have to be the kid in the hospital. We can just have some fun here, too. And the safe transportation, another thing my husband doesn't worry about. We don't have to drive two cars down here every time we come, wondering if we're going to stay or not. We can drive one car down. The van has several runs during the day. We can go and see our kids at 9:45 in the morning and come home here at 8:30 at night. And it's nice. You have time to tuck them in and kiss them goodnight, and then you're off to your own place where you have a nice, comfortable, clean place to stay. It's very, very nice. On to page two. And next is the siblings. Now, I my little guy's 15 months old, so he's not so hard. But some of our families have kids who are 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years old, and they need something to do while they're here, too. And there are so many volunteer groups who come in to the house to play music for the kids. They do arts and crafts with the kids, and so many things to help